Facts First presents Powerball Lottery Winner Loses It All. Many people dream of winning the lottery. If they won millions of dollars, all their problems would be solved. They could live in a beautiful mansion, drive a fancy car, wear only designer clothes. With millions of dollars, they'd never have to work again. There are plenty of reasons why winning the lottery would be incredible. But when Marie Holmes won, she says that it was one of the worst things that ever happened to her. What would make a woman upset about winning $188 million? Before we get into Marie's story, jump down to the comments and let us know, if you were to win the lottery, let's say $100 million, what would you do? Would you retire? What would you spend it on? Would you invest it? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. Nobody needed money more than Marie Holmes. When she won the Powerball, she was 26 years old. She was working at McDonald's and Walmart trying to support her four children on her own. Shortly before winning the lottery, she had to quit both jobs after one of her children was diagnosed with cerebral palsy. The pressure was weighing on Marie. With four children and one with a debilitating disability, the pressure was mounting. So was the bills. And now that she couldn't work, things were even worse. In February of 2015, the Powerball jackpot was up to $564 million. Before heading home to her trailer home, she bought a ticket. After the drawing, Marie checked her ticket and realized that she was a winner. She says that she almost had a heart attack when she checked that ticket. She learned two other people also had winning numbers, so she was entitled to one-third of the jackpot. Like that's anything to complain about. Many people believe that when you win a jackpot, you turn your ticket in and you're immediately given the money, but that's not the case. Big winners, they need to go through a long process to claim their winnings. There's a lot of paperwork that needs to be filled out before you can get the money, and you have to decide if you're going to take all your winnings in one lump sum or receive it in installments over 30 years. While Marie, she could have taken her share of the prize, $188 million spread out over 30 years, but she chose to take one lump sum of $127 million. Marie, like most lottery winners, chose to take the lump sum. Marie took the money right up front, assuming she'd get $127 million and be on her way. But she didn't consider the fact that she'd have to pay taxes on that. All lottery winners are required to pay federal and state taxes. The state of North Carolina, they were entitled to 5.8% of Marie's winnings. And the federal government wanted their cut too, 25%. If the winnings are in the highest tax bracket, they can take up to 39.6%. Depending on how Marie was taxed, she would have had to pay up to $50 million in taxes. Marie had already figured out what she was planning to do with her money. She planned to move out of her trailer and buy a proper home. She wanted to set up college funds for her children, and she pledged to donate money to her church. She says that she struggled to support her children for so many years, she wanted to make sure to plan for their educations. While doing this, she wanted to make sure that they understood the value of a dollar, too. She vowed not to spoil her children. Unfortunately, she made some poor decisions with that money that left her wishing she had never won it at all. Marie had a boyfriend named Lamar McDowell, and when she got her money, she bought her boyfriend a $15,000 diamond-laced Rolex. There's a waste of money. He gladly took the watch, of course, knowing that there was more where that came from. He only had 100 bucks in his bank account when he was arrested in 2014, so fortunately for him, he now had a girlfriend that could afford to bail him out, regardless of the cost. He denies that Marie paid $21 million to get him out of jail. He says that she paid just 10% of that. Still, that's a lot of money. When he was released from prison, he moved into the $350,000 home that Marie bought for her and her children. Shortly after Marie moved into her new home, people started calling and asking for money. Yeah, there's a big surprise. Friends and family members always seem to come out of the woodwork when somebody wins the lottery. And they started calling Marie about their money problems, and since Marie did have means to help them, she did. Giving a friend $10,000 didn't really seem like a lot of money, but when more and more people started asking for money, it really started adding up. This is a problem that many lottery winners have, and that's why experts suggest that lottery winners do whatever possible to keep their good fortune a secret. As if the constant phone calls weren't enough, Marie started to regret buying that dream house, too. The neighborhood she lived in was an affluent white neighborhood. The people in the neighborhood, they were not happy about a black family moving into the neighborhood, so they started to harass the family. Marie says that one of her neighbors set up a camera to record everything they were doing in the yard. If Marie were driving the speed limit, the neighbors would still wave for her to slow down. The neighbors didn't threaten her, but they did want to harass her enough to make her want to move. Marie attended the Pleasant Hill Missionary Baptist Church since she was a child. She took the church's teachings to heart, and she chose to show the church and God her gratitude by giving the church 10% of her winnings. It's called a tithe. Had Marie been able to keep her winnings anonymous, that promise might not have come back to bite her. Unfortunately, in North Carolina, the names of lottery winners are made public, according to the law. Marie kept her promise, and she donated $700,000 to the church that was in desperate need of repairs. Marie's good fortune and her donation to the church caught the attention of a pastor named Kevin Matthews. He wasn't affiliated with Marie's church, but he thought that he could get a piece of the pie. He told her that God led him to her. She and Lamar believed him for some reason, and they invited him into their home for ministerial services, and also to help Lamar make better life choices. It wasn't long before this pastor made a request. It didn't take Pastor Matthews long to show his true colors, and he asked Marie for $500,000 to help him build a retreat. And he claims that Marie agreed, although there was no written agreement. The pastor didn't want to wait for Marie to come up with the money, so he began building the retreat with his own money. And when Marie didn't put up any money toward the retreat, the pastor sued her for $10 million. Since the entire cost of the project was $1.5 million, suing for $10 million was outrageous. The stress of the lawsuit and the defamatory statements made by the pastor, Marie developed anxiety and depression. She had to start taking medication to help relieve her symptoms. When people heard about what the pastor was doing, they were outraged that a man who claimed to be a man of God would be so greedy and hurtful. A YouTuber created a series of videos about the case that was called F.U. Kevin Matthews. The pastor just wanted to vilify Marie, which caused a lot of stress. While all of this drama was going on with the pastor, rumors began to swirl about Marie and her boyfriend. Marie started hearing rumors that Lamar was cheating on her. There was even a rumor that Marie was paying off his mistress to get them to leave him alone. A video went viral on Facebook where an unnamed woman claimed she was having a relationship with Lamar and he was taking money from Marie to pay for sexual favors from other women. All of this drama, combined with the problems with that pastor, it was pushing Marie over the edge. She didn't know what to do. Finally, someone stepped forward to help Marie. Iyanla Van Zandt is a well-known author, motivational speaker, and a life coach. She also had a TV show called Iyanla, Fix My Life. She offered to help Marie regain control of her life. Marie's mother, Fontella, also went on the show, and she told Marie a secret that she'd been hiding. It was Fontella who picked the numbers but told her daughter that they were random. Fontella told the daughter that the numbers she chose were deliberate, and she picked them after having a dream that she had about Marie's brother who had passed away. Fontella used his birthday, the number 3 because he was her third child, and the number 25 because that's how old he would have been that year. She said she never told Marie how she chose the numbers because she wanted her daughter and her friends to have a better life. Lamar's gang name was Hot Sauce, and the truth about the money that Marie spent on his bail, well, it turned out that she bailed him out 3 times. Right after Marie won the cash, she bailed out her boyfriend and spent $3 million doing it. He kept getting into trouble, and less than a year later, she had to spend another $6 million to get him out of jail. He didn't change his behavior after that either. He was arrested the 3rd time. This time she paid $12 million to get him out. Lamar was taking advantage of Marie's kind heart, and each time he got out of jail, he would get arrested again. Each time, the arrests took place in front of her children. People didn't like what was happening to Marie, and she didn't like that people were bashing her for bailing her boyfriend out. He claimed that since he was the father of her youngest child, she was doing what was best for the family. As if Marie wasn't going through enough, people began bullying her. They accused her of stealing her mother's lottery ticket, even though Fontella admitted on the show that she gave the ticket to her daughter. During the taping of the show, Marie also found out that her boyfriend and the father of her youngest child was sentenced to 7 years in jail. Some even accused Marie of not being a good Catholic. Because the Catholic Church is against gambling, some people believe that she should never have bought a ticket in the first place. That's something the priests disagree with, though. Many church youth groups hold raffles, and many churches host bingo nights. How's that any different? They're all forms of gambling. The stress was wearing on Marie terribly, but between her own inner strength and help from Iyanla, she didn't let the stress break her. She managed to hold it together and do something good. Marie wanted to do something despite all the difficult things that were going on in her life. She created the Marie Holmes Foundation, which helped people who were in her situation before she won the lottery. It was designed to help struggling families and underprivileged children. Her organization often holds large events where school supplies and toys for the holiday season are given out. Anyone who wins the lottery should use Marie's story as a cautionary tale. If you win the lottery, the first thing you should do is understand the tax laws before choosing the lump sum or the monthly payouts. Also, hire a financial advisor who can help you manage your money responsibly. Finally, if possible, keep your sudden windfall private. If your state doesn't allow that, don't flaunt your good fortune online. If strangers start calling, hang up. I'd even recommend if they are relatives you haven't heard from in 30 years, hang up. It's best to try and remain anonymous if you can. If you learn anything from Marie's story, it's that you should keep quiet about your lottery winnings and get the necessary guidance immediately. This Powerball lottery winner loses it all. She managed to do some good things with her winnings, but she still wishes she had never won. Subscribe for more.